consider the doubtful ones again. There's Ermengarde.
Reverend Mother, there is no doubt about Ermengarde. The religious life is no place for the pious.
You mean the pretentiously pious, Sister Berta. There's Christina, and there's Maria.
Well, after last night, there can be no doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Berta.
Abbey.
Reverend Mother, I brought Maria. She's waiting.
Sister Sophia, the mistress of the postulants and the mistress of the novices do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her very dearly, but she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say. She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee. Her dress has got a tear.
She waltzes on her way to mass and whistles on the stair.
And underneath her wimple, she has curlers in her hair.
I've even heard her singing in the Abbey.
She's always late for chapel.
My penitence is real.
She's always late for everything except for every meal. I hate to have to say it, but I very firmly feel
Maria's not an answer to the Abbey.
I'd like to say a word in her behalf.
Then say it, Sister Margareta.
Maria makes me laugh.
How do you solve a problem like Maria?
How do you catch a cloud and pin it down?
How do you find a word that means Maria?
Of liberty, gibbet!
Open in the whistle, come on.
Many a thing you know you'd like to tell her. Many a thing she ought to understand.
But how do you make her stay and listen to all you say?
How do you keep away the puzzle sound?
Oh, how do you solve a problem like Maria?
She's a lamb.
She'll outpester any pest, drive a hornet from its nest.
She can throw a whirling dervish out of whirl.
She is gentle, she is wild.
She's a riddle, she's a child.
She's a headache,
she's an angel.
She's a girl.
How do you solve a problem like Maria? How do you catch a cloud and pin it down? How do you find a word that means
about her. I am grateful to you all. Ave, come here, my child. Maria, I want to talk to you.
Yes, Mother, about last night. I was on my knees most of the night because I was late, and after you'd been so kind to let me leave.
It wasn't about your being late, Maria.
I must have awakened half of the Abbey before Sister Margareta heard me and opened the gate.
Maria, very few of us were asleep. We could only think that you'd lost your way. And to be lost at night on that mountain.
I couldn't get lost on that mountain. That's my mountain. I was brought up on it. It's the mountain that brought me to you.
Oh?
When I was a little girl, I used to come down the mountain and climb a tree and look over into our gardens, and I'd see the sisters at work, and I'd hear them sing on their way to Vespers. Many times I went back up that mountain, singing all the way. And that brings me to another transgression, Mother. I was singing yesterday without your permission.
Maria, it is only here in the Abbey that there is a rule about singing.
And that's the hardest rule of all for me. Sister Margareta's always reminding me, but after it's too late, after I've started singing.
And the day you were singing in the garden at the top of your voice.
But it's that kind of song.
I came to the window, and when you saw me, you stopped.
Yes, it's been on my mind ever since it happened.
It's been on my mind, too. I wish you hadn't stopped. I used to sing that song when I was a child. And I can't quite remember. Please.
Wrinkles on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with string. You are a new one, my favorite thing. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wing. These are a new one, my favorite thing. Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites and the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite thing, and then I don't feel so bad.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly in the moon on their wings. These are a few of children. You're very good with them. They need a governess until September.
Until September?
Captain von Trapp expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man. And a brave one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal by the Emperor. It was for heroism in the Adriatic.
A captain of the Navy, Mother. He'll be very strict.
You're not being sent to his battleship, Maria. God bless you.
Mother, may I have your permission to sing?
Yes, my child.
These are
Yes, sir.
I was calling the governess and she didn't answer. Do you know why?
Well, sometimes she doesn't hear, sir.
I'm sorry, sir. I was answering the telephone. Good day, sir. We're happy to have you home again.
Why did the last governess leave?
Who knows, sir? She just said, I've had enough of this and walked out.
Why? Was Louisa playing tricks again, putting toads in her bed?
She didn't complain of that, sir.
Well, there's another one coming today, and this one can't leave.
Oh?
She's coming from Nuremberg Abbey with orders to stay until September.
Will you be with us for a time, sir?
Just until tomorrow. Oh, that telephone call, was it for me?
No, it was for Franz. Before your arrival, there was a call from Vienna, a Frau Schrader. I have the number in the pantry.
I know the number. Oh, I shall be back in about a month with some guests.
Do you know how many, sir?
Just two. Herr Detweiler.
Ah, Herr Detweiler.
And Frau Schrader.
Who wanted me on the phone?
It was the post office. They have a telegram for you. They'll be delivering it at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock? That gives me just 5 hours to be nervous.
With that scatterbrained boy delivering telegrams.
Well, you know, that's one of the things that people are saying. If the Germans did take over Austria, we'd have efficiency.
Don't let the captain hear you say that. He didn't whistle for us when his wife was alive.
Well, he's being the captain of a ship again.
I can't bear being whistled for. It's humiliating.
In the Imperial Navy, the bosun always whistled for us.
But I was never in the Imperial Navy.
Too bad. You could have made a fortune. You will wait here.
Captain von Trapp, you are Fräulein...
Maria Reiner.
Now, Fräulein, as to your duties here, would you mind stepping over there? Before the children meet you, you will put on another dress.
I haven't any other dress. When we enter the Abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
The poor didn't want this one.
This is what you would call a worldly dress.
It belonged to our last postulant. I would have made myself a new one, but I wasn't given time. I do make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you're given some material, today if possible. Now, you will be in charge of my children. There are 7 of them. You will find out how far they have progressed in their studies and carry on from there. Each morning will be spent in the classroom. Each afternoon, they march. You will see that at all times they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule in this house is discipline.
Yes, sir.
Your new governess, Fräulein Maria. Now, as I sound your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fräulein, will listen and learn their signals so that you can call them when you want them.
Nonsense.
Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
That is the orderly, my butler, Fräulein Maria, the new governess.
Yes, sir.
That is the executive officer, Frau Schmidt, the housekeeper. Fräulein Maria, please be sure that her room is ready.
Yes, sir.
I will leave you now with the children. You are in command.
Oh, pardon me, sir. I don't know how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to give this to you, Captain. I won't be needing it, Captain. Well, now that there's just us, would you tell me your names again and how old you are? Now you...
I'm Liesl. I'm 16 years old and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me, Liesl. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Frederica. I'm 14 and I'm a girl.
A girl? Why, you're almost a lady.
I'm Brigitte.
That's right. But you didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Brigitte. She's Louisa, and she's 13 years old. I'm 9, and you're smart. And I think your dress is the ugliest one I ever saw.
Brigitte, you mustn't say things like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I didn't think so, I wouldn't say so. I'm Kurt. I'm 11, almost.
That's a fun age to be, 11, almost.
I'm Martin. I'm going to be 7 on Tuesday, and I like a pink parasol.
Well, pink is my favorite color, too. And you must be Gretel.
Of course I'm Gretel. Who else would I be?
Well, I'm going to tell you something. Never been a governess before, and I don't quite know where to start.
You mean... you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing that you have to do is tell Father to mind his own business.
Louisa, no, I like it.
What's in there?
That's my guitar.
What did you bring that for?
For when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Of course you do. Everybody sings. Now come, tell me, what songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
No.
No. No. No. No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing. Let's start at the very beginning. A very good place to start. When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
When you sing, you begin with Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re, Mi.
Do, Re,
you're right. Well, we just do that sometimes. Now, all together, and
when you know the notes to sing, you can see those babies peeping. Go, a dear, a female dear, friends of the funny side. Me and ye, I know myself, far above a winter pride. So beautiful and grand, love to the soul.
Me? What?
Liesl, how old are you?
like it, I'm going to ask him for some more material.
More?
Oh, not for me, for the children, for play clothes.
The phone trap children never play. The captain doesn't like them to get dirty.
But they're children. They have to roll in the grass and climb trees. Just think of all those rocks and caves and all
the
that.
The captain thinks marching is the best exercise. The children will continue to march. I hope you find your room comfortable.
Yes, thank you.
There'll be new curtains for the window and the alcove. They'll be hung tomorrow.
But these curtains are very good.
There will be new curtains.
Will the captain be away long?
I don't know. Of course, he has to come home every time he hires a new governess. I sometimes think the children get rid of their governesses just so they can see their father.
He must want to see them too.
Since his wife died, they remind him too much of her. You can put that away. You won't be using it here.
Why not?
The captain won't have music here.
He won't have music?
And he used to love music. There were wonderful evenings here. His wife would sing and he would play the guitar or the violin, but now he shut all of that out of his life.
That's why he is the way he is, but to not have music, that's wrong for him and wrong for the children.
It will work out. The captain may marry again before the summer's over.
Oh, that would change everything. The children would have a mother again.
It's going to rain. You better close your window.
Dear God, now I know that you have sent me here on a mission. I must help these children to love their new mother and help them to win her love so she will never want them to leave her. Let us become a happy family in thy sight. God bless the captain and Liesel and Frederica and Luisa and Brigitte and Marta and little Gretel. And oh yes, what's that boy's name? Now God bless what's his name. Bless everyone. Know that I'm her friend, and help her to tell me what she's been up to.
Are you gonna tell on me?
Help me to be understanding so that I may guide her footsteps. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Well, you see, I was out taking a walk, and well, somebody locked the doors earlier than usual, so well, I didn't want to wake everybody up. So when I saw your window open, well, I just decided I might as well. Father,
did you climb the trellis to get up here?
Why, yes, that's how we always got up here to play tricks on the governess. Luisa can climb it with a toad in her hand.
Were you out there walking all by yourself? You know, if we wash that dress out tonight, no one will notice it in the morning. This can be just between you and me. Go put it to soak in the bathtub. You know, your last governess left so fast, she left her robe hanging on the hook. Put it on and come back out and talk to me on my bed.
I said today I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Thank you.
you tell Herr Detweiler we're having coffee out here?
Yes, sir. Herr Detweiler is still on the telephone.
No sign of the children, Frau?
No, not yet, sir.
Georg, those mountains, they're magnificent.
Yes, they're not like any other mountains. They're friendly. Look, that green stretch of woods over there, when the wind moves through it, it's like a restless sea.
And that sweet little village.
That's not a village, that's a town.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt its feelings.
It's fun being with you. You're quite an experience for me.
You're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere in you, there is a fascinating man. Occasionally, I catch a glimpse of him. And when I do, he's exciting.
Exciting? Well, I've never been called exciting before.
You know, I'm beginning to understand you better now that I see you here. You're a little bit like those mountains, except you keep moving. How can you be away from here as much as you are?
Perhaps I've been searching for a reason to come back here to stay.
Georg, I like it here very much.
Franz can't still be on the telephone. I know he's desperate about finding singers for the Kolsberg Festival, but... You like it here?
Oh, we'd have to spend some time in Vienna. I have Heinrich's estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is. I'm the president.
You, president of a corporation?
Well, I managed Heinrich's affairs for years before he died.
I just can't see you sitting behind a desk.
Well, of course, I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, Captain. Herr Detweiler would like his coffee now.
While he's telephoning?
He just finished.
I'm sorry I took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Kolsberg Festival? The finest choral group in Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in all Europe. And the best soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. Unfortunately, all I've got up to now is a basso who isn't even profundo.
Max, you always put together a good festival concert.
And why? Because my motto is, never start out looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Paris, Rome, Stockholm, London.
On Georg's telephone.
How else could I afford it? Why am I up here?
I had hoped it was because you liked me.
Well, of course I like you. Why shouldn't I like you? You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max!
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official, I... Georg, is there a cathedral around here?
Well, that's our abbey, Nürnberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good. In the next few days, I have to visit all these towns around here and listen to choirs and singerbunds and quartets.
You'll be back for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. It was in a town just about that size, Vatsp, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1930, they won the festival, became very famous, toured all over the world.
Whatever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Who lives in that dilapidated castle down there, Rumpelstiltskin?
Baron Elberfeld, the oldest family in the valley.
I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all your friends. Georg, why don't you give a dinner party for me while I'm here? Nothing very much, just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. Today it's difficult to tell who's a friend or who's an enemy.
This isn't a good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I don't know what's become of the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
Well, it couldn't have been an intentional slight because they haven't met me yet.
Forgive me. I'll go try to find them.
Elsa, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes. He hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
You don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's very simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich and you're rich.
Oh, that.
In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle. In garret rooms away upstairs, the lovers starve and snuggle. Their famous form is fortune, which they seem to have no fear of. While lovers who are very rich, you very seldom hear of.
Not a sign of them anywhere.
How can love survive?
You delivered your telegram. Now get out.
Georg, he's just a boy.
I am an Austrian. I will not be Heiler.
Georg, why can't you look at things the way I do? What's going to happen is going to happen. Just make sure it doesn't happen to you.
Max, it's a good thing you haven't any character. Because if you had, I'm convinced I'd hate you.
You couldn't hate me. I'm too lovable.
Herdette Weiler, there's a long-distance call for you. It's from...
I'll take it.
And report back here. At once? Fräulein? Where did they get those abominations? Out of a nightmare?
No, out of some curtains. The ones that used to hang in my room. Oh, they had plenty of wear in them.
Just a moment. Are you telling me that the people of the neighborhood have seen my children wearing old curtains?
Oh, yes, and they've become so popular. Everyone smiles at them.
I don't wonder.
Yes, they say, look, there go Captain Von Trapp's children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
Oh, but Captain, they weren't. They were just little unhappy marching machines.
I don't care to hear from you about my daughters.
I know you don't, but you've got to hear it from someone. You're not around long enough to know them.
I said I don't want to hear.
I know you don't, but you've got to. Take Liesel. She's not a child anymore, and if you keep on treating her like one, Captain, you're going to have a mutiny on your hands. And Frederica, she's afraid to be herself. She's shy, she's aloof, she needs your confidence.
Don't tell me about my children.
Brigitte could tell you, because she notices everything. She always tells the truth, especially when you don't want to hear it. And Kurt, he's sensitive, and you ignore him. You brush him aside the way you do all of them. I'm not finished yet. Louisa, she just wants to have a good time. You've got to let her have a good time. And Marta, I don't know about yet, but someone's got to find out about her. And little Gretel, Captain, she just wants to be loved. Love them all, Captain, please.
Stop.
Please, Captain, they need you.
Stop it. You will pack your things and return to the Abbey.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said those things, not the way that I said them.
After you've gone, there'll be plenty of...
Hear the sound.
What's that?
Of
singing.
Singing? Who's singing?
Your children.
My children. Singing.
I wanted them to sing for Frau Schreiner when they met him.
Georg, you must hear.
Martha, Edith, Martha, you're Louisa.
you.
Thank you.
The captain was really moved.
Yes, I think he was pleased. He's asked me to stay on with the children.
Oh, you're staying on?
Until September.
September?
And then I go back to the Abbey.
The Abbey?
I'm going to be a nun.
Oh, how nice. Mm. When you get back to the Abbey, think of us.
I'll pray for you.
People I've invited aren't speaking to the other half.
Well, Father, maybe they're having a good time not speaking to each other.
Sir, Frau Schrader asked me to let you know she'll join you.
Thank you. You might see whether she would like this glass of bread. It's done.
Your face is all red.
I guess I'm not very used to dancing.
Well, hello there.
Good evening, Frau Schrader.
I hope you're feeling better, Frau Schrader.
Yes, thank you, Kurt.
Come on, guys.
Hello, Uncle Max. We're having a party.
Good. Tell your father it's sure to be a success. I'm here.
Max.
Elsa, you are without a doubt the most beautiful corporation president in the entire world.
you're back. And as usual, just in time for dinner.
Georg, did you think you could get a gala without me?
Oh dear, now we have an odd man.
A little odd, but charming.
Liesel, run and ask Frau Schmidt to set two more places, and I want to see Fräulein Maria.
Two places?
We need another woman.
Who? Liesel?
Oh no, she's much too young. I'll ask Maria.
You're not serious.
Of course I am.
She's a nursemaid.
I don't think of her that way.
Well, I don't mind, but your friends. You can't ask them to dine with Maria.
And why not?
Well, Elsa, tell her why not.
Max, can you change in a hurry?
All right.
Yes, Max, we can use you tonight.
Frau Schrader, they're talking about you out there.
Come on, Georg. I've been dodging these people for an hour.
Brigitte, have you seen your father?
Good evening, Fräulein Maria.
Herr der Father, it's nice to see you again.
Yes, you're going to.
I know no law. Frau Schrader didn't have a headache. She was just trying to get out of the party. She was faking.
Now, you shouldn't say things you don't know are true.
But I do know. I heard her say to father she's been dodging these people.
Well, that doesn't mean she didn't have a headache. No, it's very important for you children to like Frau Schrader.
I like her all right. Why is it important?
Well, I think she's going to be your new mother.
Oh, Fräulein, father's never going to marry her. Why, he couldn't.
Why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Brigitte,
you must know that.
No, Brigitte, no.
Remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing the Edelweiss song he taught us? When we finished, you laughed at him for forgetting the words. He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you. And when he speaks to you, the way his voice sounds.
No, Brigitte, no.
And the way you looked at him just now when you were dancing. You are in love with him.
One more dance, Gretel, then to bed. Oh, Maria. You won't be having dinner with the children tonight. You'll be dining down here with us.
Oh, no, no.
Oh, yes, it's all been arranged. You'll have to hurry. You'll have to change. Oh, and Maria, wear that dress you wore the other night when we were all singing together. It was lovely, soft and white.
Shall I announce dinner, Cass?
Oh, no, not yet. The children will want to say goodnight. Oh, Georg, I wanted the children to say goodnight the way they did last night.
Oh, no, not here.
Please, Georg, the way they did it for me, it was so sweet.
No, no, not in front of strangers.
Please, Georg, for me.
Presto, change-o.
Max, you're just in time. Children, now.
Tell us, but friendly they compel us to say goodbye
to you.
extraordinary.
Fräulein Maria taught them to do it.
I've been looking all over Austria for something like this for the festival, and I find it here.
Wait a minute, Max.
A singing group of 7 children in 1 family. They'll be the hit of the festival.
Max, Georg didn't even want them to sing for the guests here tonight. I had to persuade him.
Then you have influence. You must talk to him.
Max!
It's for the good of Austria. And it wouldn't do me any harm.
Maria has asked to see you. I know it has taken her a long time.
I waited until she wanted to come to me.
It's strange. She's happy to be here, but she's unhappy too.
Why did they send her back? Do you know?
She doesn't speak. She hasn't spoken except in prayer.
I shall see her.
Maria.
You anything?
It's told me that I never want to leave these walls again.
Why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left. I left without telling them I was going. I left without saying goodbye.
Maria, what happened? Why did you do this?
I was frightened.
Frightened?
I was confused. I felt... Oh, I'd never felt that way before, and I knew that I couldn't stay. And I knew that here I would be away from it, that here I would be safe.
Maria, our abbey is not to be used as an escape. What is it you can't face?
I can't face him again.
Thank you, Sister Margareta. Maria, are you in love with Captain Von Trapp?
I don't know. I don't know.
Tell me about it, my child.
Well, Brigitte just said that I was and that her father was in love with me. And then there he was and we were dancing. Well, I could hardly breathe. And I said then that I knew I could not stay.
But do you do like him, Maria?
Oh, yes.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I didn't know that I didn't. That's what's been torturing me. I was sent there on God's errand. To have asked for the captain's love would have been wrong. I don't know. But I do know this. I'm ready at this very moment to take my vows of poverty, obedience, and chastity.
Maria, the love of a man and a woman is holy, too. The first time we talked together, you told me that you remembered your father and mother before they died. Do you remember? Were they happy?
Yes, Mother, they were very happy.
You were born of their happiness, of their love. And my child, you have a great capacity to love. What you must find out is, how does God want you to spend your love?
I've pledged my life to God's service. Pledged my life to God.
My daughter. If you love this man, it doesn't mean that you love God less.
You must find out. You must go back.
Oh, don't make me do that. Please, let us stay here.
Maria, these walls were not made to shut
sing seriously. Please, will give us a key.
Do.
That's nice. It's very nice. Except it's no good. Imagine you're standing on the stage of a big concert hall.
What concert hall, Uncle Mac?
Any concert hall. Maybe Carlsberg Concert Hall, but a concert hall full of people. All right, let's try it one more time.
Do.
Gretel, why don't you sing loud?
I got a sore finger.
Oh. There, now you can sing loud for Uncle Mac. The night of the party, you sang so beautifully, with such spirit. Well, let's try it again.
Do.
Experience with choirs and quartets and glee clubs.
Max, please. Now, what do you want to sing? So, a deer, a female deer, raised from a golden sun. Me, a maid, I call
Fräulein Maria.
We are not to mention Fräulein
Maria. Come on, Max. I feel like a brisk walk.
That's just what I need. Is anyone using the car?
Now, what are you going to sing? Jokes on Fräulein Maria.
Only those that she liked and laughed at.
You didn't put any toads in her bed.
No, Father.
Well, something must have happened for her to leave us without even saying goodbye.
Isn't Fräulein Maria ever coming back?
No, darling, I don't think so.
She was the best governess we ever had.
Well, you're not going to have a governess anymore.
Oh, good.
I'm not sure that's good.
You're going to have a new mother.
A new mother? Frau Schrader?
Well, yes, it was all arranged last night. I'm very happy. Well, it's time for your afternoon walk.
When Fräulein Maria used to feel upset, she used to sing that song, remember?
Yes.
Well, all right, let's try it.
Louisa, forgive me. Maria will be in the nursery.
come back?
Yes, Captain.
You left without even saying goodbye, without any explanation whatsoever.
Forgive me, it was wrong.
Well, why did you do this to us? Tell me.
Please, don't ask. Anyway, the reason no longer exists.
Then you're back to stay.
No. Only until arrangements can be made for a new governess.
Oh, no, the children missed you terribly. I've missed... We all missed you very much. Nothing was the same while you were away. Everything was wrong.
But I...
We'll talk about it later. You go up and see the children now. Maria. A new dress?
We have a new postulant.
Make out that stone wall down there. That's the property line.
You see?
I didn't argue about it.
I know, that makes me furious. I don't like to win without a fight.
Hey, Detweiler, while you were gone, you had a long-distance call from Berlin.
Gee, I wonder who'd be calling me from Berlin.
They said you'd know who it was.
Oh, thanks, Franz. Georg, what were we just talking about?
Max, that's not the first call you've had from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no political convictions. Can I help it if other people have?
Let's not stir that up again. The Germans have promised not to invade Austria.
Then
Max knows that.
Then why does he keep taking those calls from Berlin?
Because if they don't keep their promise, I would have some friends among them.
Naturally.
Oh, so you agree too?
Georg, this is the way I look at it. There was a man who was dying. They were giving him his last rites. They asked him, do you renounce the devil and all his works? And he said, at this moment, I prefer not to make any enemies.
If they should invade us, would you defy them?
Yes.
Don't you realize what might happen to you? To your property?
To your children?
To everyone close to you? To Elsa? To me?
Well, what will you do if they come?
Well, what anyone with any sense would do. Sit tight and wait for it all to blow over.
You think it will?
One thing is sure, nothing you can do will make any difference.
Don't look so serious, darling. Take the world off your shoulders.
Relax. You dim, attractive, dewy-eyed idealist. Today you have to learn to be a realist.
You may be bent on doing deeds of daring do, but up against a shark, what can a herring do?
Be wise, compromise.
Compromise and be wise.
Let them think you're on their side, be noncommittal.
I will not bow my head to the men I despise.
You won't have to bow your head, just stoop a little.
Why not learn to put your faith in your reliance on an obvious and simple fact of science? A crazy planet full of crazy people. It summers molten all around the sky. And every time it turns another solar eclipse, another day.
Living, there'll be nothing else as wonderful as I.
Each one is important to himself. But you can't save yourself by giving up, and you don't outwit a lion by putting your head...
Your call from Berlin, sir.
...in the lion's mouth.
I'll call them back.
You might as well talk to them now, Max.
Go. Go, go.
Gail, I feel I know what's going to happen here. Can't you see things my way?
No, not as long as you're willing to see things their way.
There's one thing you do better here than we do in Vienna. Your sunsets. I'm going to miss them.
Pardon me.
Maria! Gail, you didn't tell me Fräulein Maria was back. I'm delighted.
Captain, the children would like to know if they can take a holiday from their lessons tomorrow so that we can go on a picnic.
Yes, I don't mind.
That will make them happy. And may I be permitted to wish you happiness as well, Frau Schrader, Captain? The children tell me that you are to be married.
Oh? I'm afraid the children were wrong. Georg, I must finish packing my things if I'm going to get back to Vienna.
If you feel you must. Tell Franz to have the car ready.
I can do that.
Auf Wiedersehen, Georg.
Goodbye, Maria.
Sorry if I said something I shouldn't have said.
You did say the wrong thing. But you said it at the right time.
The children told me that you were to marry Frau Schrader.
We found we just couldn't go the same way. That door is shut.
Sister Margareta always says that when God shuts one door,
I know, he opens a window. Maria, why did you run away to the Abbey? What made you come back?
The Mother Abbess. She said that you have to look for your life.
Often when you find it, you don't recognize it.
No.
Not at first. Then one day, one night, all of a sudden, it stands before you.
Yes.
I look at you now and I realize this isn't something that has just happened. It's something I've known deep inside me for many weeks. You knew it too. What was it that told you?
Brigitte. She said that when we were dancing that night.
She was quite right. It wasn't just an ordinary dance, was it?
I hadn't danced since I was a very little girl. Quite different when you're all grown up, isn't it?
When you were a very little girl, did a little boy ever kiss you? That's quite different, too.
Is it? It is different.
Your whole life will be different now. I'll take you anywhere you want to go, give you anything you wish.
But I don't want to go anywhere. All that I could wish for is right here.
An ordinary couple is all we'll ever be. For all I want of living is to keep you close to me. To laugh and weep together as time goes on its flight. To kiss you every morning and to
together sometime.
Who?
The Mother Abbess and Brigitte.
Yes.
Thank you, Reverend Mother.
No!
Thank you.
kids, come look! Cultsburg Festival, 1938. The Pontrap family singers, and there's all your names. Liesel, Frederica, Louisa, Kurt, Brigida, Marta, and Greta.
Because you're the youngest.
Now, Liesel, I'm depending on you. Day after tomorrow, everybody needs to be ready by 11.
Can you help me, please? Jarl is here, and he wants to know why we're not flying the new flag.
Hot!
I tried to explain.
Keep quiet. When is Captain Von Trapp returning?
Who knows? When a man is on his honeymoon.
These are not times for joking. It's been 4 days since the Anschluss. This is the only house in the province that is not flying the flag of the Third Reich.
You mean the flag with the black spider on it?
Tina, do you permit such remarks in this house? Who are you?
I'm Maximilian Detweiler, First Secretary of the Ministry of Education and Culture.
That was in the old regime.
In the old regime, I was Third Secretary. Now I'm First Secretary.
Good. Then you will order them to fly the flag.
Captain Von Trapp would not... I mean, I can only take my orders from Captain Von Trapp.
You will take orders from us, and so will the captain. Hi!
Why was he so cross?
Everybody's cross these days.
Is Father going to be in trouble?
He doesn't have to be. The thing to do today is to get along with everyone. Now, Lisa, be sure everybody's on the bus by 11 o'clock.
Uncle Max, are you sure this is going to be all right with Father?
He'll be pleased and proud.
Lisa, do you think so?
Well, Brigida, don't you trust me?
No.
Well, anyway, the bus leaves at 11 o'clock.
Children, see what I have here?
That's Father's luggage!
Yes, they're back.
No, Lisa, they'll have such a lot to tell us. Let's not hurry about telling them anything. Telling each other to be quiet. We miss climbing upstairs to say goodnight to you.
Oh, we miss hearing you sing.
You came just in time to hear us sing. Look, Father, we're going to be in the Cultsburg Festival Friday night.
Let me see that. Max, are you responsible for this?
Georg, I was just waiting to talk to you about this.
You're not going
to
talk your way out of this one. Look, Max.
Presents!
Oh, come along to the nursery.
Georg, we didn't expect you back till next week.
Well, Max, it's good you're here. There's much I want to know.
I had to make a last-minute decision on this. I was lucky to enter them at all. They'll be the hit of the festival. 7 children in one family.
Not my family.
But the committee already heard them. They were enchanted.
Oh, Max, really, what did they say?
You never heard such praise.
Oh, Georg, did you hear?
The Von Trapp family does not sing in public.
But if they make people happy...
And for the festival, people come from all over the world.
It's out of the question.
It's for Austria.
There is no Austria.
The Anschluss happened peacefully. Can we at least be grateful for that?
Grateful? To these swine?
You must at least pretend to work with these people. I admire the way he feels, but you must convince him. You must compromise.
No, Max.
Maria, you must.
I cannot ask Georg to be anything less than what he is.
Then I'll talk to him. If these kids don't sing in the festival, it would be a reflection on Austria. And it wouldn't do me any good.
Maria, I always knew you loved us children. Now I know you love Father.
I do. I love him very much.
But how can you be sure?
Well, I don't think of myself first anymore. I think first of him. I know how to spend my life.
Waiting for life to start. Somebody kind to touch.
have my orders.
Silly, they're married!
Oh, Franz. This telegram is to be delivered directly into the hands of Captain von Trapp.
Hi.
Hi.
Franz?
Yes, even Franz. Even me, even everybody in Nuremberg except for the great Captain von Trapp. If he knows what's good for him, he'll come over to the right side.
Ralph, don't say things like that!
And if he doesn't, he'd better get out of town. There are things that can happen to a man like that today. He'd better get out quick. Cry all you want, but just remember what I said before it's too late. And you remember, too.
Liesl, don't cry.
Well, how would he turn on Father that way?
Maybe he's not threatening him. Maybe he's just warning him.
Liesl?
Well, what is it, Georg?
I didn't think I'd have to face a decision this soon. Berlin has offered me a commission in their navy.
Well, Georg?
I can't just brush this aside. What I mean is, it would be a comfort and a relief to know that you and the family are safe. But it would also mean... Maria, please help me.
Georg, whatever you decide is my decision.
Thank you. I know now I can't do it.
Of course not.
We'll have to leave Austria immediately.
You'll have to leave tonight, now!
Not without my family, and we can't just pack up and leave. They'll be watching us now. We'll have to plan.
Hi!
We'll have to have time.
Sir, Admiral von Schreiber of the Navy of the Third Reich is here to see you.
Thank you, Franz. They didn't give us time.
Then we'll have to make time.
We'll have to be careful. I'll bring them in.
What's going on here? Stormtroopers? This is what I was afraid of.
You
Maria.
Stay here with Georg. We must find the children. Quickly, quickly.
This way, Admiral. We can talk in here. Admiral von Schreiber, may I present Herr Detweiler. Max, I believe you already know Herr Zeller. Would you gentlemen care to sit down?
We are here on business.
Captain von Trapp, a telegram was sent to you 3 days ago.
I've just received it. I've been away. I've only been home half an hour.
Captain von Trapp just returned from his honeymoon.
Congratulations, Captain.
Thank you, sir.
Your record in the war is very well remembered by us, Captain.
It's good to hear you say that, sir.
Let's get to the point.
If you don't mind. In our Navy, we hold you in very high regard. That explains why I am here. Having had no answer to our telegram, the High Command has sent me in person.
That's very flattering, sir, but I've had no time to consider
it. I am here to present you with your commission.
I'm deeply conscious of the honor, sir, but I...
And your orders are to report immediately to the naval base at Bremerhaven.
Immediately? Georg, I don't think that's going to be possible for you, dear.
Admiral, may I present my wife, the Baroness von Trapp, Admiral von Schreiber.
Madame?
What I mean is we're going to be singing at the Carlsberg Festival Friday night. The von Trapp family singers, right there in the program.
All arranged by the Ministry of Education and Culture.
Friday night? This is Wednesday. That's a matter of only 2 days. It might be possible. You can report to Bremerhaven by Monday.
Admiral,
is there a telephone I could use?
This way, Admiral. If there is any question, maybe adding the weight of my voice. It gives here only the names of the children.
It says the von Trapp family singers. I am head of the von Trapp family.
It's hard to believe, Captain von Trapp, you singing in a concert.
Herr Zeller, you may believe what you choose.
It doesn't say here what you're going to sing. What are you going to sing, Captain?
It is your privilege to come to the concert and hear us.
But I'd like to hear you sing now. Sing what you're going to sing in the concert. Sing!
Thank you.
an announcement that concerns you. Ladies and gentlemen, the festival concert has come to its conclusion, except, of course, we don't know what that conclusion is going to be. The judges are putting their heads together now to arrive at their decision, and while we're waiting, I think there should be an encore. It seems this may be the last opportunity the Von Trapp family will have to sing together for a long time. I've just been informed that Captain Von Trapp leaves immediately after the concert for his new command with the naval forces of the Third Reich. A guard of honor has arrived to escort Captain Von Trapp directly from this hall to the naval base at Bremerhaven. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the family Von Trapp again. Gentlemen, I have with me the decision of our distinguished judges. We will start with the third award. For this honor, the judges have named the trio of the Singerbund of Erwägen. Thank you. The second award has been given to Fräulein Schweiger, first soloist of the choir of St. Agatha's Church in Mörbach. Right. And the first award, the highest musical honor in the Ostmark, the family Von Trapp.
Where are they? The Von Trapp!
They're gone!
Gone? The Von Trapp family?
Which way did they go?
Where could they be? Call the guard! Call district headquarters!
Play something!
many of them are there?
I counted only 8 stormtroopers and their officers.
Sister, we have no idea we'd be putting the Abbey in this danger.
This is outrageous. The church has always been sanctuary.
Not with these people. This is the 3rd time they've searched the Abbey. That's why we put you out here in the garden. They always search the inside, never the outside.
Isn't this God's house?
Yes, darling.
You must be very, very quiet. We'll let you know as soon as they've gone.
After they've gone, can we go home?
No, darling, we have a very long drive ahead of us.
Liesl, please, we have to stay close.
These mountains as my friends standing there protecting us. And now they seem to come by enemy.